Overseas, markets started the day mixed, and right now we're going to take a look at individual exchanges as well as stocks with Laura Boards in the Deal's London newsroom. Laura, what's the latest you're hearing?
Hi, John. Let's talk about the economy first of all, because obviously worldwide everyone is pretty obsessed with what's going to happen when the Fed begins paring back its bond buying program. We had some good news on Sunday from China. Exports surged far more than expected. The trade surplus is at a near five-year high. The November figure for exports rose to 33.8 billion from 31.1 billion the month before. And that's an increase of 12.7% year on year. That really encouraged stocks in Asian trading today, which otherwise may have been a little alarmed by the very, very strong US figures on Friday, non-farm payrolls and third quarter GDP revisions. In Germany, however, we've had a surprise on the negative side. Industrial output has come in unexpectedly less in the month of October than September. Instead of rising about 0.8%, as economists had expected, actually fell 1.2%. On the corporate side, over in Australia, QBE Insurance Group has shocked and disappointed investors by predicting a full-year loss of about 250 million Australian dollars. That's around 227 million US dollars. Its problems in North America, and specifically provisions for claims and goodwill write-downs, and the stock ended the day 22% lower. In Europe and in the UK, in fact, Kent's has made an acquisition people rather like. It's buying the field solutions unit of Valaris from TPG. This is all about US shale and expansion into the US and Central and Southern America. It's paying a modest 8.5 times EBITDA for the business, and investors have given the deal a thumbs up, sending Kent stock up about 10% in morning trading in London. Back to you, John.
Thank you very much. That was Laura Board in the Deal's London newsroom with the latest.